On today's celebration of Resident Evil's 25th anniversary, I'm playing the demo of a fan remake that's based on Code Veronica, a video game that deserves more appreciation and inevitably a remake. Regardless if you played the original game, there's going to be some slight spoilers.
But nothing major that would sabotage the entire experience, so enjoy your Ventures experience.
And after extensive waiting, this demo finally begins with Clara Redfield locked inside of the same prison cell as she was in the original version of Code Veronica. Except this time, she has her modernized look from the 2019 release of Resident Evil 2's remake. And somehow the door is already open, although we haven't already used the lighter to trigger the first cutscene. The most important first decision to make while playing Code Veronica is to obtain the knife because it's overpowered and saves you plenty of time. Okay, this shit over here wasn't there when I first played Code Veronica, but that's besides the point. Over here, we've got Discount, Carl Winslow, Eddie Murphy, Mike Tyson, and a goddamn brawler stance. Last time I checked, you have an injury. There's nothing in there? Well, at least I got this herb. I mean, it'll be very useful anyway. You know what? I'm getting very suspicious about you. You can't just be standing there for nothing, so I'm just gonna get rid of you. Okay, there's your sign of dominance. Huh? What the fuck are you doing? Whoa! What is all this shit you're doing? This fucking hybrid of fighting moves? No! Fuck you! Die! I've gotta stop this guy before he gets out of control! There's no way I'm letting this guy get near me like that! What are you doing? Get out of my way! This shit is ridiculous! And somehow a miracle! Because this motherfucker is shadowboxing with a fatal injury! This isn't the way that I remember Code Veronica. I don't remember any of this shit being here. But that's okay, because I know that this is a fan remake. And hopefully someday Capcom remakes the whole game and makes it just as innovative. What the hell? Oh, thank you. Finally, something. Can I open? Nope, can't open that. Now let's see if I can see. There's no knob. What is it with Resident Evil not having knobs on doors, or that shit just breaking off easily? What is it with all this shitty interior decoration? How in the fuck did Rodrigo come to the cell and not by any chance get locked out by not having the key? Anyway, the good thing about it is that I don't have to worry about being locked in here with this goddamn deranged shadow boxer. Yeah, this is definitely different from the last time I remember playing Code Veronica, because usually Claire would come upstairs and have her heart beating because she's nervous. Which I thought was an interesting decision, because throughout Code Veronica, she does the same thing with other situations. But in Resident Evil 2, she's already proven to be a strong female protagonist. Okay, let's do- No, not that! The knife! Oh shit, I gotta get the knife. Get the knife out! Shit, okay, here we- I already have it on- What?! Okay, I gotta get it now. I'm using the controller for this, not the mouse and keyboard. Come on, die! Fuck. God damn, they pack quite a punch, don't they? Okay, this is going a bit different than I expected, because in the original version of Code Veronica, you could easily kill them with the knife that you have by aiming at their legs. That knife was very overpowered, but it was a great weapon to use. But these enemies here seem to be stronger, which is a great challenge, but still. Damn, Claire is getting her ass kicked already, and these bastards aren't going down faster. Finally. Alright, now we can get through here. There better not be another one. Where's that noise coming from? Whatever. Anyway, I need to get Claire healed because there's no reason for her to die this early. Code Veronica has historically established itself as one of the major Resident Evil titles encouraging players to collect and utilize herbs. And Claire is over here limping as if somebody shot her kneecap. But I'll admit, I actually like that little attention to detail the same way Capcom did it by having characters hold their arms and stomachs as if they're fucking constipated. Shit, I can't go through here? I guess not yet. I may as well just go through here and meet Steve for the first time before he fires his goddamn machine gun as if he's John Rambo. I never really understood why Steve would shoot at a human being who clearly could open the goddamn door. Okay, there we go. Claire needs another herb because she can't hopscotch her way to the inn. Ah, that's great. Handgun ammo. Wait a minute. I don't think I'll have enough ammo to take out all of these zombies. Because I also know that there's going to be dogs. But I'm more concerned about Claire being on the verge of death and not having enough ammunition to take out all the enemies if they're just as overpowered, which would also fuck up this entire situation if she doesn't have enough items to heal and defend herself with. I've mastered Code Veronica, so I would know. Believe me, it's not that fucking simple unless you've got it figured out already. Now I've got two of these bastards to worry about. But I don't believe that I have enough items to defend myself with. How is Claire gonna get through this whole area if she's hip-hopping? Ugh, even with the handgun equipped, it still doesn't feel like she's completely protected. This is equivalent to Claire awakening naked, with only being able to utilize the knife. But honestly, that would have been a great challenge because it would have simultaneously taught players how to strategically use it, while also being able to manage their inventory space without wasting items. Yeah, fuck that. You're gonna have to stay over there and not bother me so I can go in here and find the M100P weapon. I'll just go through here and hopefully find the weapon and then get out. But there's also a zombie that's supposed to drop them, which makes it even more irritating that I have to go through all this just for one goddamn weapon that should already be here. Oh, that's right, there's another zombie over here. But usually you'd have to fucking take the handgun ammo and then kill the other enemy before that bastard wakes up. But I can't even find the M100P because the fucking enemy didn't even come through the goddamn window when I collected the fucking handgun ammo like in the original game! I've played Code Veronica enough times to know how to defeat these enemies without wasting ammo and getting killed in the process because of complete incompetence. But the problem with Code Veronica's release in America is that unfortunately there's locked difficulty settings that can only be accessed through cheating software. Most of the people that I've interacted with about the game have talked about how difficult it is and never acknowledged that. If you're out there and probably spectating right now, or if we've never met, get the Japanese version, physically or through emulation. Yes, I'm absolutely advocating that video games that deserve to be preserved gets preserved. Okay, motherfucker, it's time to stop hitting Claire. I'm getting out of here right now. What the fuck is that? It was obviously time to leave because Claire would have been a goner if she stayed longer. But the good thing about leaving is that now I could use a herb without any of the enemies ruining her health anymore. But that's not going to change that the enemies are still appearing in places that I don't fucking want them to, thus making this survival horror journey more difficult. Oh, look, there's more boxes over there. And hopefully they'll actually have useful items and not just sitting there at convenience completely fucking empty. God damn it! Oh, thank you. Okay, this is another area that I never explored in the original version of Code Veronica because it simply didn't exist. But let's check out what's in here. Aside what I think may be just fire. Well, that answered my question. This whole place is burning down to hell. Wait, what's that? Is that rifle ammo? Why is there rifle ammo next to the fire? I don't know if the developers realize this, but if bullets are set next to heat, they could explode. That's a fucking hazard in itself. But I'm more surprised they didn't already blow up with that fire being around that long. But I've got another question on top of that. I'm not saying that I'm ungrateful about this, but why in the hell am I already collecting rifle ammo when it's impossible to get the sniper rifle from Alfred Ashford until you get to the Antarctic base in the original version of Code Veronica? And by the time you actually get the sniper rifle, it's only temporary until Claire is taken hostage by Alexia. Again, I'm not trying to sound ungrateful, because it would be great to have that type of weapon right now with these motherfuckers somehow taking so many bullets! And still would have been helpful against the T078 tyrant you're forced to fight twice in Claire's side of the story. There are two out of the most annoyingly challenging boss fights, but at least one of them involving water and electricity could be entirely avoided. But I'll save that for my Let's Play. Aw, shit! Hold on! The key to the padlock I'm searching for is over there. But I can't get to it unless I turn the power back on. And that's only after Steve enters some mysterious combination that Claire never knows about on the same switch that I'm supposed to fucking touch. Okay, I'm gonna skip all this. Alright, now that that metal detector business is temporarily over, it's time to meet Steve. But over here is also the copy machine that I'll need to use for the Hawk emblem. But I can't get the Hawk emblem until after I meet Steve. And after I find the Hawk emblem, I'm gonna have to use the fire extinguisher to put out the fire that allows me to get the briefcase to find the special alloy required for this whole goddamn puzzle. And then of course I'll have to use the special alloy made out of the emblem that I just copied on the giant gate that's outside of this area to get out of the prison camp. I could guarantee you this entire journey requires a lot of backtracking, but that's nothing new in Resident Evil and nobody should be complaining. Okay, finally I can get the emblem. Gotta go right in here. Yep, I'll take that, thank you. Can't use the computer for some reason, I don't know why it's off.
Okay, gotta press this. Come on.
Yeah, there we go.
Okay, I have enough space now just in case I have to get more items, knowing that this is a fan remake and not actually the whole game. Alright, I'll take this out and put it right inside this machine. That way now, when I get the fire extinguisher and put out the fire and get the briefcase, I'll be able to have enough inventory space. Also because of the fact I don't know what the hell I'll be dealing with next. Okay, let's get that extinguisher that I need to use for the fire. Those zombies are going to come right out of here when I press this button, so I better be prepared anyway. Okay, Huh? Wait a minute, where the hell is the fire extinguisher? And what the hell is this case that's telling me that it's locked? Well, that certainly wasn't here when I played Code Veronica. The only briefcase that I remember is covered in fire. And the only time Claire would ever be able to open up a case like this is when she gets the lockpick. Which I don't have right now at all. Actually, I need to check something. It just occurred to me that I've never tried opening this lock. Holy shit, it does work. Well, that's good. I hope Capcom actually introduces that in the real remake. Now what I'm going to do is investigate this whole area because I haven't checked this place and I never thought that I could actually get over here. I figured that maybe I'd need a key or maybe it was just completely inaccessible. But now that I know that I can access this area, I would like to figure out what the hell is behind this door and if maybe there's any useful items. Oh, that also reminded me. Before Claire arrived here, she was attacked, so that's why she's limping. Okay, you rotten son of a bitch. Stay right where you are so I can shoot you from this distance. I mean, I'm glad that I could shoot them from right here without missing, but I think it's just weird that these... No! Okay. I just thought that it was weird that these zombies have so much energy, but being shot in the head multiple times without going down immediately. It already seemed like it was being foreshadowed in previous entries, especially in Code Veronica, with not only having progressively difficult enemies, but the difficulty at default being hard. This would especially apply to Resident Evil 3, because regardless what difficulty was selected, Nemesis remained annoyingly frustrating. Motherfucker, here we go again. Okay, this time is going to be different. I'm going to blow your brains out with this gun. I don't know how the hell I'll achieve that with the way how this game is working with physics, but I'm going to try. God damn it, I've shot you enough times already. Just fucking blow up already, holy shit! Okay, now it's your turn, motherfucker. Stand right there and don't come any closer. Stay in that direction and take all of the bullets. Okay, come on. Come on. Come on. Come on! I almost have this. Come on, do it again. Booyah! Ah, that's that. No more zombies. Except all of these dead bodies here. I mean, holy shit, they got really fucked up. Okay. That's all, right? There's no more zombies over here? Good. I can't cut open this one. I thought I might find an item. Oh, man. These guys really got torn up. But I would expect them to go here, you know, instead of just being buried in the graveyard. What's over here? This door's locked. Can I get a key for this door? I mean, I just got here, so I would figure maybe I could unlock it at some point. I mean, if Capcom does create a place like this in their actual remake that I hope happens, I would expect them to be able to allow us to open some doors and not just have them all entirely inaccessible. Alright, you need to stay the hell over there and stay the hell away from me. Now, there's something over here that I noticed. Yeah, right there. What the hell is that? Let me just get this. Alright, I need a... What is that? Some kind of puzzle piece or something? A jewel. The jewels weren't introduced until later when we play as Chris. Huh. Yeah, this really is a remake because all kinds of shit is being switched around. And also, I'm trying to figure out where the hell that goddamn fire extinguisher is because I needed to put out the fire! Well, in the meantime, I could go down here and put the doorknob on that door because I figured out maybe if I could just use this thing for something, it could just be for another door that doesn't have anything on it. Like I said earlier, it's weird for Resident Evil to have this type of terrible interior decoration. Whoever's doing this shit should have been fired and thrown out of a window. And possibly eaten by a flock of vultures that flew out of Raccoon City. Well, now it's time for the moment of truth. Let's see where the hell this door leads to. A bathroom.
What the? Okay, this fucking wild goose hunt for this fire extinguisher has gotten out of hand. I don't know if this is supposed to be a joke, but the bathroom was the least place I would expect to find this. Out of any area I could have found this fire extinguisher, I least expected this bathroom because now I'm thinking about Metal Gear Solid again. I'm thinking about how Johnny Sasaki would still take the time to take a massive shit despite the zombie apocalypse occurring. It's unlikely he would die anyway, regardless how much time was left before the whole island exploded. Okay, I need to see if I can actually use this fire extinguisher and it's not here just as a prop. One of the other interesting things about Code Veronica is that when you have the fire extinguisher, you're tasked to reuse it again. But you never know when you have to reuse it until it's too late. And when I figured that shit out, I was absolutely upset because I wasted all that fucking time trying to figure out why the hell it's still there. What happened? Wait a minute! What? What in the fuck did you mean that I couldn't use this fire extinguisher to put out the same fire that's covering up the briefcase that has the alloy that's required for me to make the goddamn emblem? How in the hell am I supposed to make the emblem if I can't find the briefcase? Claire cannot open any briefcases that have fucking locks on it without the damn lockpick! Well, unfortunately, this is the end of the video because I've tried searching high and low for the damn lockpick. Also, I've discovered that you're forced to redo the entire demo if Claire dies once. Setting all that aside, I did enjoy the demo for what it tried to do. It's obviously not finished and has a lot more content ahead, and it's definitely undoubtful that I'll replay once it's completely finished. That is, if it's ever completely finished. But until that day happens, including Capcom finally remaking the game themselves, this was the Venturous Gamer, and I hope you've enjoyed your Venturous experience. Play dead. That's right. Good dog!